Hey there, interwebs, and welcome back to Who? Fascinating. If you know anything about Gertrude of Nivelles, it's probably that she's the patron saint of cats, and therefore she must have been a crazy old cat lady, right? Wrong. Every part of that is false. She wasn't crazy, she didn't live long enough to be an old lady, and at no point in her brief lifetime was she ever associated with cats. She's officially not even a saint. If Gertrude's not the patron saint of cats, who was she then, and why do we think she is? Much of what we know of old Gertie's life comes from her anonymously authored biography, the Vita Sancti Gertrudis, and the fascinating part began in the late 630s when she was 10 and refused to be married off to the son of a duke from Austrasia. Don't question it, that's just how things worked back then. You're an old maid if you didn't have 3 kids in college by age 12. It seems she was getting a head start on those rebellious teenage years because she threw a fit and refused to marry him or any other man and swore she'd have no spouse but Christ himself. Never settle for second best, ladies. It's speculated that had her father lived longer, he would have forced her into the marriage, but he died the following year, and Gertrude and her mother moved to Nivelles and founded an abbey which still stands today in modern-day Belgium. This was likely a deliberate, calculated ploy by her mom to protect the two in case the brothers fell out of favor with the ruling dynasty and to ward off any attempts by suitors to forcibly marry into the influential family and plunder their lands. Following her mother's death in 652, Gertrude, now in her early 20s, took over as the abbess of Nivelles and fully launched her religious career. The Vita tells us she was, quote, an intelligent young woman, scholarly and charitable, devoting herself to the sick, elderly, and poor, unquote, and was welcoming to widows, orphans, pilgrims, and foreigners, especially Irish monks. Although never officially canonized as a saint, she still racked up the requisite 2 miracles to her name. The first occurred when she was standing in prayer at the altar of Pope Sixtus II and beheld a great ball of translucent flame which descended from on high and illuminated the basilica for about half an hour. The second occurred nowhere near her. According to her anonymous biographer, he was peacefully sailing abroad on monastic business when suddenly a sea monster appeared accompanied by a terrible storm. The pagan sailors turned to their idols for protection, but one passenger and friend of the author cried out to Gertrude for salvation. Immediately, the frightful monster retreated back beneath the waves and the storm dispersed. I don't know about you, but even assuming that the event did occur as described, I'm still hesitant to give Gert credit for saving the day. What evidence do we have that it was her and not the sailor's pagan deities that scared off the monster and dispelled the storm? There were an awful lot more people invoking them than Gertrude. Even if we can't attribute the latter miracle to her, we also can't deny that she was nonetheless charitable to a fault, which would prove to be her fatal flaw. It's well documented that she frequently went without sleep while holding vigils and practiced pious fasting, and this ascetic lifestyle as an anchoress took a harsh toll on her health. It forced her to resign as abbess in 656, and she died only 3 years later in her early 30s on the feast day of St. Patrick. So, where do the cats come from? Due to her famous hospitality and salvation of the sailors, Gertrude became the unofficial saint of travelers, which included the recently deceased, who were on a journey of their own and everyone needs a good psychopomp. She prayed for those whose souls were detained in purgatory, and it was a trend in medieval art to depict them as mice or rats, so her iconography often included rodents. At this point, it seems more like she should be the patron saint of rats, not cats, so what happened? Well, because of her association with rodents and getting them out of places, i.e. purgatory, she was the one often invoked by people attempting to rid their houses of infestations. After some time, this figure also became associated with cats, since both were used for chasing away mice, and thus Gertrude of Nivelles became the unofficial patron saint of cats. Yes, this feline cult of hers is an ancient and time-honored tradition, dating back almost 4 entire decades. That's right, Gertie's cat lady status only began in roughly 1980, more than 1,300 years after she died. Also, she went from the saint of rats to the saint of cats because she was invoked to chase off rodents, but she was also invoked to chase off a sea monster, so maybe she should be the patron saint of sea monsters as well. Thanks for watching, and have a fascinating day.